Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. And I do suggest that you consider hiring me to come on site for a team building and educational training event for you and your team. In this episode, I want to talk about what happens when we combine constexpr and mutable. Now, I do have a workshop coming up soon at NDC Tech Town, and I am planning to give one at CBPCon 2023. So be sure to check those things out, as well as t-shirts and books and other things that I have going on. Now, the first most obvious place where you might want to apply both constexpr and mutable is in a lambda. Now let's look at this pretty straightforward example, the kind of thing we've done many times before on this channel, where we have a generalized capture in our lambda that is creating a variable called I of type int, and we have marked the lambda mutable so that it is allowed to mutate its captured variables, and each time we call it, we increment this value so we can keep track of how many times the lambda has been executed. So we can see that this one has been called twice. Now, these two versions of this callable struct are morally equivalent for the sake of discussion about this particular topic. Every time I invoke the call operator on my user-defined lambda type, I am going to increment the variable I and return the last value for it. Now, the difference between this mutable being here and not being here, if I take away the mutable, then that's the same as adding a const here, and it becomes clear I cannot modify a member variable if I have a const member function. And that is the same here in the lambda. So you need to check out the video that I did where I cover just a ludicrous number of topics, all revolving around lambdas. So let's go back to the mutable so this compiles. Okay, now if I make my lambda constexpr, then this code can no longer compile because constexpr implies const. So let's just get rid of the constexpr and say I've got a const object. My lambda is const, the closure object that was created by this lambda expression is const. And when I'm trying to call the paren operator on it, I have a const this pointer, and then I hit this no match for call to const lambda. So a const mutable lambda is uncallable. There's really not very much you could do with this. Well, that's not true. I could make a copy of it at runtime, and there might be a reason to do this. If I want to somehow create a complex lambda at compile time and then copy its trivially copyable data into a runtime lambda to then mutate, there might be some logic to doing this in some cases. Let's dial this back and let's go back to this version here, and we're just going to play with our own lambda object. I've created a lambda object and I am calling it. This is my own user-defined type of lambda. If I were to make this constexpr and I initialize this object at compile time, I'm back in the exact same boat that I was in before. I cannot call this non-const member function. Well, if I make this const, I can no longer mutate my member because I cannot mutate a const object. Now, if I declare my member to be mutable, now I actually can create a constexpr object at compile time, and then modify some portion of its state at runtime. Now I've just pasted in this slightly more complicated version that is linked to in the video description. And let's go ahead and look at what we've done here. I have this data object and it is initialized with a couple of, well, we're not going to say complicated values, but it has to do some work. It takes the first input and it adds 10 to it. It takes the second input and it subtracts 100 from it. And I store those. One of them is const, the other one is going to be mutable, because I am creating a constexpr object and I am passing this to some unknown thing called useData. And I did that so that the compiler does not optimize away everything that I did. And the result is that we actually end up with this teeny tiny data table in our compiled code, where we know the first value is 20 because that is 10 plus 10. And the second value is minus 58 because that is 42 minus 100. So it did these calculations at compile time, and it was effectively required to. I just moved this into O0. We can see that we no longer have a data table in our binary, but these two values, 20 and minus 58, did in fact get hard-coded into our executable. So it's an interesting idea. I could use a constexpr constructor and a constexpr object to force the compiler to initialize some portion of the data at compile time, and then use it in a meaningful way at some point in the future. But arguably, const eval would be the better way to do this. By making that constructor const eval, I've required the compiler to do the exact same work at compile time. But now the entire object is mutable. I don't know. It's an idea. If you actually find yourself deploying something like this, please leave a comment in the video description. But otherwise, thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Hope it gave you a little bit more insight into the language, and be sure to subscribe.